Hey guys, so I was thinking of doing a new Let's Play, and with the recent release of Guy Ritchie's second Sherlock Holmes film, and the fact that his movies have caused a sort of renaissance for the character, I thought I'd play some of the Sherlock Holmes games. So today I'm going to be playing Sherlock Holmes and the Mystery of the Mummy, which should be a fun little adventure game. I've played it before a long time ago, but such a long time ago that I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to do it all from memory. So yeah, at some points I might take edit out where I take a while doing the puzzles. I'll let you know, whether it be through actual voice recording or actually just edit on a little capture on the screen, I'll let you know when I edit stuff out. I'll also... I don't think I will need to use walkthroughs at any point, but if I do, I'll admit it. So don't worry about that too much. Okay. So let's start.
Dear Sherlock Holmes, thank you so much for your interest in this affair. Finally, I've found some peace after knowing that the matter of the disappearance of my father, Lord Montgarth, 6 months ago, is now being investigated by you, my saviour. I know that you will find the truth, and you will tell me exactly what happened to my father. Yours sincerely, your devoted future cousin, Elizabeth Montgarth. P.S. Please, I beg you to keep this business a secret. I really don't want your dear cousin Andrew, whom I'm going to marry very soon, to find out about it.
It is very fortunate that Watson is away. I'll be able to make inquiry and keep it secret as my cousin wished.
That doesn't really sound very much like you'd want Holmes to sound, does it? By any definition.
Mr. Sherlock Holmes, I suppose. Here is a letter for you from your cousin, Elizabeth Montcalf.
Thank you very much. Good luck, Mr. Holmes. So it is the manor of Lord Montcalf. Seems no one is at home. I'll try to find evidence proving his death and report them to my cousin, Elizabeth.
So nobody's home. Right, let's just make sure this is recording. There. Let's try doing that without dropping my mouse. Okay, it turns out it was recording. I probably should have assumed as much. Because checking by alt-tabbing crashed the game. Right, so here we are. Okay, this is one of the older ones, but this is the first one Frogware made. And it's a lot... It's not even a full 3D, in fact it's pseudo 3D. These screens look 3D, but you can't actually move around them. Let's see, I can't remember exactly.
I should read the letter from Elizabeth again.
Okay, okay, it's not in your bag. Thank you so much for your interest in this affair. Finally, etc, etc, etc. He was a brilliant man, one of Egypt's best Egyptologists. Always bring through to senses. Elizabeth Montcalf. Please keep it a secret. Thank God that Watson's not around, hence we can pretend this is canon, and he just didn't write it down. I cannot give you the key to the manor. I don't believe that such an obstacle will stop you, but I'm ashamed to ask you to force the home of my father. I fear that the manor is filled with traps, as my father lost his mental health 5 months before he disappeared. Be cautious, our happiness depends on your success. I've only got the two letters so far. I should read better, Elizabeth. Yeah, that's just all what I've said, that's convenient. I'm going to save it. Let's see here. He's an Egyptologist, so... That's creepy. Well, let's hope you can't see the little Skype thing that's just popped up around there. OKMKNKLD.
The answer to this conundrum must be somewhere in this room.
Does that not look like Sanctum? Okay. Okay. 2700 This is the sort of game where you're going to have to wind up writing stuff down. LD period. What ones did we need again? I should have actually written them down. OKMKN.
The answer to this conundrum must be somewhere in this room.
NK?
Incredible, it is a real museum.
As opposed to one of those fake museums.
It is a real museum.
I think that's the right ones. Is that one? Yes. I will admit I'm doing this partially from remembering this is sort of how the puzzle goes. And then I'm going to find out that I'm remembering it wrong entirely. Huzzah!
It is obvious.
Thank you. That totally belittles everything that I just did. Was it on this side? A key. See, I've got a key. This is very strange looking at all this pseudo 3D stuff. Before I remembered that. What was that? Some sort of seal. Not the water-based seal.
I need a key to open that door.
Really? Really? You need a key, do you? Let's see, how do I... come on. How do I use the key? How do I... oh, there we go.
Unlock.
It's lucky that he says everything. Unless, of course, being that this is first person, it is in his head. See here.
This is the mummy of Kai Peset, priest of Aton. I didn't know that Lord Monkath had such archaeological treasures at home. This is the mummy of Kai Peset, priest of Aton. I didn't know that Lord Monkath had such archaeological treasures at home.
Yep, it's lucky his cousin's marrying into this family.
Here is the famous curse of the Kai Peset mummy.
Ah, oh, please don't pretend to.
It's illegible.
Well, look at such a low resolution, isn't it?
It's... all these pieces must have been taken from the tomb of the priest.
can spot that one.
Sorry,
I keep clicking on him.
I didn't know that Lord Mountcath had such archaeological treasures at home.
Oh. What the hell is... Oh, I can click on it. Oh, I'm standing in a box, am I?
These tools might be helpful.
Let's see what I got there. I've got a new seal, obviously. Oil flask. A hammer with lever. And a screwdriver. Pardon me. Let's see. I can barely see that. A tie pin. How convenient.
Again, a room full of Egyptian relics. Does Lord Mountcath have a big collection?
I'm so glad the later games have a different voice actor, or at least someone who managed to refine their voice. Yeah.